module, we're talking about what are called integrated rate laws, and specifically for first order rate laws. So first, let me show you what I mean by first order. So what we mean by the order of a chemical reaction, it's just the sum of the powers in the rate law. So for example here, if this were the rate law, and this is rate law, for a chemical reaction, the overall order of this reaction would just be the sum of the powers for all of the species involved in the rate law. So the first power here plus the first plus the second adds up to four. We say it's fourth order overall. We could also talk about the individual species. We say that it's first order with respect to bromate, first order with respect to bromide, and second order with respect to hydrogen ion. Now, we can have a zeroth order reaction. If it is zeroth order overall, then the rate is just equal to K because the concentration to the zeroth power is just one. If it's first order overall, we can say the rate is equal to the K times the concentration of the reactant. And second order overall means that it's equal to either K concentration of the reactant squared, or if there's two reactants, it could be concentration of one times concentration of the other. So, focusing on first order rate laws. So we know that the rate is equal to negative change in concentration of A over change in T. Again, calculus is not a prereq for this course, but after using some calculus, it ends up, after we integrate this, we get the result, which is called the integrated rate law for a first order reaction. This you need to memorize. This LN stands for the natural logarithm, the natural log of the concentration of the reactant at some time, okay? At any time, the natural log of the concentration at any time is equal to negative the rate constant, K is the rate constant, times whatever time it is of interest, plus the natural log of the initial concentration of the reactant. Rearranging this a little bit, we get another useful form, the natural log of the ratio of the initial concentration to the concentration at time T is equal to the rate constant times that time. Memorize both of these forms of the integrated rate law for first order chemical reactions. So the integrated rate law is in the form of the equation of a straight line, y is equal to mx plus b, where y is the natural log of the concentration of the reactant at a given time, and x is going to be the time, t. The slope of the line will be negative the rate constant, and the y-intercept will be natural log of the initial concentration. So for this reaction down here, decomposition of acetaldehyde, if we plot just the concentration versus time, we do not get a straight line. It's not a straight line. But if we take the natural log of the concentration versus time and plot it, we do get a straight line. And that is one of the ways that we commonly determine whether or not a reaction is first order overall, is to plot the natural log of the concentration versus time. If we get a straight line, then we can be confident that we have a first order reaction. Also, notice that it's kind of small here, but I got the equation of the straight line for this reaction, for this set of data. And remember, the slope is negative the rate constant. So the slope for this line is negative 0.012, which means that the rate constant, K, we now know K is equal to 0.012 positive minutes to the minus 1. Minutes to the minus 1 because the time is in minutes and K is just 1 over whatever the time is in. So we're going to use that in a minute. All right, so another example. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to use the two forms of the integrated rate law that I've shown you. So this problem here, azomethane, this molecule here, decomposes according to this reaction. We're told that it's a first order process and we're given the rate constant K, 4.0 times 10 to the minus 4th per second. We want to calculate the fraction that remains after 35 minutes. So because we don't know the initial concentration, we're going to have to use a form where we have just the ratio of the two concentrations, the second one that I gave you, of the first order rate law. This form right here. So even though we don't know the initial concentration, but we can find the rate, the fraction that remains after some time. But the fraction that remains, it's the concentration at that time divided by the initial concentration, the inverse of this. So we'll take care of that in just a second. But a couple things first. First is, because our rate law, our rate constant is in inverse seconds, our time has to be in seconds. We are given it in minutes, so just converting it to seconds, we get 2100 seconds. And so the next, okay, to get rid of the natural logarithm, we have to take the inverse function, which is the exponential function of both sides. So e to the natural log gets rid of the natural log, and we have e to the kt. So this here, we've just taken e to both sides. Now, okay, we want the ratio, the fraction that's remaining. So that means we want the inverse of this ratio here. So we just flip it upside down, which means we get e to the minus kt, you know, 1 over e to the kt, e to the minus kt, same thing. So now, okay, all we need is k. We're given that, plug that in. When we do, we get the ratio, the fraction that's remaining. E to the minus 4 times 10 to the minus 4th times 2100 gives us 0.43. So a little less than half is remaining after 35 minutes. Check my, you know, put this in your calculator, make sure you guys get the same thing. Okay, another example. So earlier, those graphs that I showed you was for the decomposition of acetaldehyde. Now we want to find out how much at the concentration of acetaldehyde that remains after 65 minutes. So now here, because we have this data, we know the initial concentration. We can use the first form of the integrated rate law that I showed you, this guy right here. Because we know this, we know the time, we know the rate constant, we can find the concentration at any time. Right. A couple of things. 65 minutes is halfway between 0 and 130. So at first, sometimes people say, well, isn't it easy? We just take half the initial concentration, 0.0430. No, it's not linear in terms of the concentration. It's a natural log that's linear. So we have to plug into this equation. So remember, we got the slope of the line, and that was 0.012 per minute. And so the negative sign here and the negative sign here make it negative. The time is 65 minutes. The initial concentration we get from this table, 0.0860. We're not worrying about units. The natural log kind of does away with that. Just put the number in. And when we multiply this out and add them together, we get negative 3.23. That's the right-hand side of the equal sign here. That's equal to the natural log of the concentration of acetaldehyde at 65 minutes. So to find the concentration, we just take e to both sides. That gets rid of the natural log. E to the minus 3.23 is 0.0394, not 0.0430. There we go.